you do a good job with this, right, apart from hiding the hair and clothing, etc., you won't be able to recognise it from a distance. I mean, right in front of your face you will, but you know, 15 metres back, say in the woods, you wouldn't recognise that person.
I feel much more confident now and I feel happy to interview people.
These 2 days have been a lot better as we did a lot more exciting activities than I expected, such as the escape and evasion exercise through the woods.
It was like much better than I expected and I thought the escape and evasion exercise was really fun.
Past 2 days I think have helped like the team bond a little bit and has improved our skills while interviewing more people.
I think those 2 days were very helpful with the whole journalism. It was just helpful to talk to people.
Grass he puts here, if he stands over there, he's going to clearly be a distinctive outline as a person, is he? So you're trying to break up your outline as well. That's why we put camouflage over our heads and our shoulders predominantly, because it starts to break it up, okay?
Just waiting for the right moment for someone to like get caught and act as a decoy. And when the lady like stepped all the way back, that's when I started running.
A lot of you have worked very hard there, guys. Okay, so well done for that one. And so from our side, good effort. Even the mad rush by the girls there, sort of about halfway through, okay, did slightly take us by surprise.
What do you think is the most satisfying thing about your job?
Inspiring the younger generation, showing them that there are other careers they can do in life, not just in the military, but that they can fulfil their potential. If that then happens to be in the Royal Air Force, then that's absolutely brilliant, but that's what I enjoy doing most.
So why did you choose to do this job?
The responsibilities, because it's a good challenge, it's a difficult job, and it gives me something to sort of sink my teeth into, if you like.
Why did you choose to join the RAF?
I chose to join the RAF because I wanted to fly. And I wanted to be in the military. As a kid, I read all the books like Biggles and comics and that kind of thing. And I just thought it could be a cool job, an interesting, different, and a challenge as well. And it is all those things.
What are the highlights of learning to fly?
Learning to fly, I get to pull G, which is a good feeling on the body. I get to visit all across the country and as well as Europe. And then hopefully in the future, I'll be going into war zones and helping out other countries in humanitarian.
Air Commandant, what are the highlights of your job?
Well, I do enjoy my job, I have to say, and the real pleasure is working with young people and seeing them develop.
Working here, you must feel a sense of history.
You can't escape it, and we're in this wonderful room called the Trenchard Room, and I was speaking to you before about some of the magnificent paintings we've got here. You know, as we walked down from the office, we saw just a very small amount of the history. It's a protected building. It is fantastic. It is the world's first independent air academy, and we're very, very proud of that.
When you're in charge of a lot of people, sometimes it can feel quite lonely out there because you're having to make quite big decisions on a lot of issues, be that from personnel to finance to infrastructure, lots of things, and it's my decision to make those.
What do you especially enjoy about your job?
The variety, number of different things that happen to me every day and every week. No 2 days are the same, so there's always something new to look at.
My sole responsibility is to recruit all nurses into the Royal Air Force. There's only one person that does it, and that's me.
It is fantastic. It is the world's first independent air academy, and we're very, very proud of that.